exactly why.
What was that about?
She spat in my face. Or might as well have. Called me a whoremonger and a witless hack. Can you imagine? Wit is my forte.
Gotta say, Priscilla's really growing on me.
Save it.
And why don't you save your pouting? Prove to her she's wrong.
Exactly what I plan to do. I've always dreamed of having my own cabaret. A bit of paint and plaster, and this place will do splendidly. Just one hitch. I need coin. So, if you happen to get a break between drowners and ekamajigs, maybe you can help an old friend out.
How much do you need? Maybe I can lend you the coin.
Thank you, Geralt, but I refuse to take a single crown from you. You know what they say. Fastest way to lose a friend is to loan him some coin. But a favor? That's different.
What kind of favor?
I dated this girl once, Sophronia. That's a name if you can believe it. Has a merchant for a father, importer of spices from Zeracania. And Daddy Dear would never refuse his daughter Dear a thing. We can borrow the coin from her!
Fine. Tell me what you want. Got a feeling you've a plan all cooked up.
Sophronia could still be holding a grudge after our unfortunate parting. But with a touch of help from you, I know she'll forgive me. And then give me that loan.
What's this help entail?
First of all, we need to borrow a dull sword from Madame Irina. One of her props. You know, the kind they use during performances? Get that, then meet me outside Sophronia's house.
Fine, but...
Geralt, the only butts in this plan will be the ones filling my seats. It'll work, you'll see. Get the sword from Madame Irina and meet me outside Sophronia's at sunset.
Oh, man, it's a material world.
What?
You never given me nothing but floppy diddly. Saying I'm not good.
What's he schemed up this time?
What village are you from?
Willows. Said to me earlier 2 days running from the
Got my area. Eye on you, white one. Looking to make some coin too, hey? Right. Your paler's dead.
So good to see you.
Got a request. Need to borrow one of your props. One of the swords you use for stage battles.
My. Whatever do you need that for?
I don't know. But Dandelion claims it's essential.
Oh, yes. I suspected Master Dandelion might have a hand in this. I certainly hope you don't aim to compete with me. Well.
Thanks. I'll try not to damage it. So long.
Truth is, we're already dependent on the Black Bones, economically.
Stop scaring us, decent folk.
Interesting.
Fucking hey, Oz. Witcher.
Looks like a drop of some sort.
Everywhere.
Truth is, we're already dependent on the Black Mountains, economically.
Ah, finally made it. Listen, here's the plan. Sophronia loves adventure-filled romance novels. I can be a hero in her eyes if I can just save her from a bandit. I'll have her eating out of my hand, and there's no way she'll begrudge me that loan.
Want me to be the bandit?
Knew you'd see the sense in it right away.
Are you serious? That's your brilliant plan?
I never called it brilliant, but any kind of plan is better than none. Written your lines already.
You've written what?
So you know what to say during the performance. Here, Andromask, put it on. Sophronia can't recognize you.
But...
No time. Sophronia's coming. Stick to the plan. We'll meet at the Rosemary in the morning.
Stop right there.
What is this? Help! Save me!
Tremble. Flaxen-haired wench. Bow before the Prince of Thieves.
Not so fast. Drop your sword, scoundrel. This is your first and last warning.
Dandelion!
'Tis I, though the scum of the city call me the Crimson Avenger.
No, not the... Crimson Avenger.
Silence, vermin! You shall regret the day you were born. Come on!
Dogs!
You're better than I thought.
Come on, come closer.
Go on, Dandelion! I mean, Crimson Avenger!
The Crimson Avenger triumphs again.
My hair! Are you well?
One blow struck true. Another scar from my collection.
Come inside. I shall bandage you up. Be gone, vile bandit, or the Crimson Avenger will beat you senseless!
They're so desperate to change their name now to non-human.
I serve the eternal fire! Walking about all dour-faced, scaring decent folk.
Old man Newman left me a gift last
What's
time.
What's the hurry?
What?
My prince.
He never given me nothing but floppy diddly.
You must make more as a mama than you do wishering.
What are you doing? Not enough time already.
Nah, just hopped out.
There's been a misunderstanding. You're here too early.
We agreed to meet today, so we've come today. Supplies are all hauled in and the crew's raring to work. We'll start just as soon as our lovely directress gets round to deciding on the decoration.
But Dandelion doesn't even have the coin to pay you.
Turns out he does now, or soon will. At any rate, he's working on it.
See? It's all peachy. So will you finally decide what style you want for this interior?
What are our choices?
Master Dandelion said he was torn between boudoir style and theater decor. Promised to let us know his choice as soon as we arrived. Now we're here, but no decision's been made. And the lady's horribly surprised she's to choose. Though apparently this whole renovation's for her sake.
For me?
Well, it's not for me. Now, would you please decide where I bust a vessel?
I've no idea what Dandelion did. Geralt, you've known him long. Say something.
Boudoir seems like a better fit for cabaret. Just don't go overboard on stuffed upholstery.
A wonderful choice it is. At last. Gentlemen, you're done lollygagging. Get to work.
Well, well. Guess this cabaret's the real thing.
Ever since Dandelion inherited this place, he's talked about it constantly. I just never expected him to take action. And so quickly.
Who knows? Might even settle down now. He'll have to keep an eye on the business. Who would have known?
Despite what people say about him, Dandelion approaches life very rationally.
We talking about the same Dandelion? Man who loses a fortune worth half of Novigrad in one night?
Dandelion can also be responsible. He always pays anyone who works for him on time, and he's never missed a performance.
Sure hope your opening won't be the first. He's still not here.
Well, he said as soon as he got the coin, he'd go see Polly, our choreographer. She's missed the last few rehearsals. I certainly hope he's not gotten into trouble.
Anything's possible with Dandelion. Let me see if I can't find him.
Eternal fire.
You look fucking amazing. I saw
on
it.
Top of me.
Everyone's always on.
What's the ruckus about?
Polly and her half-brained fiancé. They're fighting. She's the only one in this town who knows anything about choreography, and that lummox won't let her work for me. Hold on. What are you doing here? We were gonna meet at the Rosemary.
We were, but you didn't show. Priscilla started to worry, so I came to see how you were doing.
Priscilla started worrying about me? That's so nice!
Less for her than for you, I'm sure. So let's get back.
Did you not hear what's going on in there? We've gotta help Polly! Why do beautiful women always end up with such dicks?
No idea. Stand back. I'll break the door down.
Wait! Do we have to destroy her house? She keeps a spare key around here somewhere.
How would you know she keeps a spare key around here?
It's not as if we started working together yesterday. Before Polly joined forces with Hubio...
You'd visit her? Often?
I'd hide out here while Priscilla and Polly rehearsed at the Rosemary in Time. They worked on the dance numbers. I composed.
So, Polly's not one of your...
I never mix business and pleasure.
The one exception being Priscilla.
Who you were just saying is worried about us. So enough of the chatter and start looking.
Fine. Let's find the key.
You look familiar.
Find anything?
Not here. The key.
Everyone's always on me.
Whoa! What the devil's this? Get out of my ass!
Watch it, and leave the woman alone.
What the... She's my betrothed.
But I'm not your property.
I love her. I'll not let her sway her ass in his brothel.
Whoa, slow down there a minute. This is clearly one gigantic misunderstanding. One I can clear up in the blink of an eye.
Shove your excuses up your ass. Sod off, or I'll split your skull.
My friend asked you nicely, so please be courteous in return and hear him out, or we'll settle this another way.
All right. Talk.
Hubio, right? Polly's told me so much about you. She said you're erudite and have an open mind.
You said that? Well, there's a truth to it. My mind's the open salt, but its open-saltedness ends when my betrothed starts wagging her ass around brothels. Get out of here, both of yous. Polly's not going anywhere.
Let him finish. There's no brothel involved.
You see, friend, Geralt just hit the nail on the head. For what you have there is the old publicity placard.
Old?
Very. From a time when my establishment was under different management. I, however, would never let any indecency take place in my cabaret. My very reputation precludes it.
So, what's all this about?
Your betrothed is a first-class artiste, and I want to offer her a position worthy of her talents. She's to be my choreographer, and that in turn means she'll receive a share of the proceeds from every performance she choreographs.
You mean to say coin?
And fame. No flirting required. You have my word.
Suppose... in that case...
I knew you'd agree.
It's settled then. See you at the Rosemary, Polly.
Well, I'm off.
I'll catch up to you. Whew. Never expected that to go so well.
You handled it well, Dandelion. Man was putty in your hands once you called him erudite.
In negotiation, as in combat, the key is to find your opponent's weak spot and exploit it to the hilt.
So, time to head back?
I've still got to stop by Rotlix. Commissioned some new placards from him a while ago, but Hubio came across the old version. Plowing artists got some serious explaining to do.
I'll go see Rotlix. You head back to the Rosemary, or Priscilla will have my head.
Really? You'd go?
No, said that for the hell of it. Tell me where he lives.
Portside.
See you soon.
Every man for himself?
Me? The more I drink, the clearer I think. Think he's punishable by death?
Huh?
Boring.
Looking to make some coin.
Looking for Rotlix.
You ain't alone. Damn halfling's in debt to half the city. But I'm here to scrape mine before the carcass is picked clean.
There's not enough for everyone, so bugger off. Feeding time's first come, first served.
You're not gonna rob him.
Strange, don't recall asking your permission. Get him, Fred! You'll regret this, mutant.
Closer.
Tell me what you want. Damn it!
Placards.
There ain't no plowing placards here.
And Rodlick, where's he?
Same place as always. Fecal Bud Estate. Losing his last crowns at the races.
See? Wasn't that easy? Could have said so right away.
Well, Rodlick, seems you're a
You, Rodlick?
Henri Rodlick, artist, painter, debtor, and martyr to my art. At your service.
Dandelion sent me.
Oh, yes. Well, tell him his placards are done and safely hidden away. Yet, alas, I cannot fetch them, as a group of angry creditors has seized my home.
Think I might have run into one of them.
Then you know my predicament. And now, Count de Louverton has offered me the chance to win it all back. I'm to wager on a race.
What's there to worry about? This is your chance to settle up, get a clean slate.
We've had a spell of bad luck lately. Should I agree to de Louverton's offer and lose, I shall be in bondage to him for all time.
Let me pay off your debt. No strings attached.
Thank you. I never expected this. May I ask to what I owe this generosity?
Let's just say I like to do a good deed from time to time. Can we get those placards now?
I'll bring them to the Rosemary in time. Just as soon as I settle my obligations.
Fine. See you there.
Sadists thought to change their name now to Non-Human Hunters.
So?
Well, well. See, the crew's been hard at work. Not bad.
No. No, not all. But I'd imagine something more, you know, more theatrical. What about Rodlick? Did you get the placards?
Rodlick said he'd bring them on his own. Should be here soon.
Great! The best way I can think of to promote the chameleon.
Guess everything's ready. So when's the opening?
Soon. We start our dress rehearsal in an hour. I just need to nip back home for my dress.
Thanks for everything.
Don't mention it.
Seems my cabaret dreams are about to come true. So, around to celebrate? I'm buying.
Why not?
That's my boy. The foreman mentioned he saw you and Priscilla talking.
He saw right.
And she say anything about me?
She said something that made me think she's not entirely normal.
What?
That you're responsible, got your feet planted firmly on the ground.
You're pulling my leg.
Not this time. One thing's eating me. How do you manage to get the loan from Sophronia?
Oh, wasn't easy. She got so excited about our performance, I had to read to her for 4 hours. 4 hours from the cloak and the dagger.
You mean you didn't...
Are you crazy? Who do you think I am?